Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a session whereby we are going to interact and learn together. We are going to have our biology from 4 lesson 14, whereby your tutor will be me, Mr. Gerald. We are going to unload the topic on the reception, response and coordination. Under the subtopic, tropisms. Remember, we have got reception, response and coordination either in plants and animals, but here we are going purposely to deal with the plants in this lesson. But before that, we can have the following lesson goals, whereby by the end of the lesson you should be able to define different tropisms. So let us begin and explain. We have got different types of tropisms in plants, whereby the first tropism we have phototropism, whereby in but before that we can explain what are tropisms, whereby these are growth movement of part of plants in response to a unidirectional external stimulus. Tropic movements are shown by growth curvatures of plant parts. These responses are either positive or negative when growth is away from the stimulus. These growth movements are often slow because the growth rate is controlled by plant hormones, especially the auxins. Tropisms like that tactic responses are named according to the stimuli which evoke them. Now, I would like us to look at different types of tropism, and I've said in this lesson we are going to look at the tropisms in plants. The first type of tropism that we are going to look at will be phototropism. This word is coming from the word photo, meaning light. So, in simple terms, we can say phototropism is the response of plants in response to light. The shoots are positively phototrophic, while the roots show negative phototropism. What we mean, as you can see from our diagrammatic representation, this is what we are calling phototropism. You can see the plumule or the shoot is growing towards the source of light, which is the sun, which in this case we are calling it the stimulus. So that's why we are saying that the shoot is positively phototrophic, while the roots, because they are growing against the light, that is the stimulus, we are saying the roots are negatively phototrophic. When we come to our second diagram, we are going to look at something we known as geotropism, whereby geotropism, we are saying that this refers to growth curvature in response to gravity. So as we look at our second diagram here, we are looking at a plant which is whereby the roots are growing towards the soil, and we are saying that this the roots are positively geotrophic, while the shoot is negative. It has got negative geotropism. The reason is because the shoots are growing against gravity. We can have our other type of tropism, which is known as hydrotropism, whereby we can say hydrotropism, these are growth curvature in response to water. We can have a diagrammatic representation of the same. So in our diagram, actually you can see that the roots here, they are growing towards water, and this one normally is evident in hydrophytes, whereby these plants, these are the plants that grow in places where there is plenty of water. So in our that diagram here, you can see that the roots are growing towards the water, so we can see that the roots are positively endotrophic, while the shoot is growing upwards, whereby it is going toward the direction where there is no water. So the shoot is has got negative hydrotropism. We have got another one which is known as chemotropism, which whereby we are going to say these are growth curvature in response to chemical concentration. So actually there are some plants which grow toward certain chemicals and others grow against certain chemicals. The plants which show a positive chemotropism are the ones which grow towards certain chemicals, and others, they also show a negative chemotropism. We have our last type of tropism in plants, which is known as digmotropism, whereby we can say this is a growth curvature in response to touch. For example, if you look at actually the plants, some plants lack a supportive, their stems cannot support on themselves. So they have got, they develop this type of tropism known as digmotropism, such that they can support themselves through other plants. Actually, they use what we call the tendrils. We have got the plants like the passion fruit. It uses its tendrils to climb other plants. The response, it has got positive. The tendrils actually have got positive the hemotropism, because they are able to detect other plants such that they can be able to go through them. We have got the survival value of trophic responses, or the importance of trophic responses, where we can see one, phototropism exposes the leaves in position to maximum light absorption, thereby enhancing photosynthesis. We have got another importance, whereby endotropism enables the roots of the plants to seek water. We have what we call geotropism, enables plants, but that is the plant roots, to grow deep into the soil, thus offering firm anchorage to the plant. We have what we are calling chemosynthesis, whereby it enables the pollen tubes to grow towards the embryo sac, thereby facilitating fertilization. Having done and said that, we can have the following activity, whereby you are required to explain the survival value of trophic responses. For more of this lesson, you can refer to KLB, Secondary Biology Student Book 4, which is the 4th edition. And for this lesson and many more of our biology lessons, you can send us an SMS through the number that is on our screen, or you subscribe to either our YouTube or our Facebook page, which are both Elimu TV, or you can tweet us at Elimu TV_Kenya. Let us subscribe and we shall enjoy our biology lessons. Thank you.